Today's presentation will be about Kermetico and the HVAF coatings we have been creating most recently. Think of it as an update on our technology. We have been producing equipment in Benicia, California since 2006, and since that time we have installed 60 systems worldwide. We also use the equipment in our shop to provide coating services for our customers, who are mostly refineries. This has given us the opportunity to design equipment which meets the needs of our customers' applications. Our high-velocity air-fuel process is characterized by a low combustion temperature, about 1,000 degrees less than traditional HVOF. This results in solid particles rather than liquid particles. They absorb oxygen at a rate about 1,000 times less than liquid particles. And further, since we're only dealing with 1/5 of the oxygen, as in an HVOF process, we don't much oxidize the outside of the particles as well. Because of the design of our gun, we have very efficient heating of the feedstock materials and have spray rates as high as 73 pounds an hour with our largest gun. We have a number of different product lines within the Kermetico family of thermal spray equipment. The oldest and first is the AK line, pure air, no oxygen. Coatings come out with a very high hardness, and because of the high spray rate and high deposit per pass, the cost is lower. This is also attributed to the fact that we're not putting as much heat into the part, and we don't have to wait for it to cool off for so long. We also have our convertible system, which is newly introduced. It's a technology we've been using for some years here in the shop, but as a product, it's brand new. Here, we have the ability to add oxygen to our process to raise the temperature of combustion just enough so that we can melt or soften the larger HVOF specified particle sizes and achieve coatings that exceed HVOF characteristics in virtually all cases at much higher spray rates and deposit rates. So many of the benefits of HVAF transfer into our HVOF coatings. We also have developed a specialized series of guns that are designed for a specific application, like spraying low melt point materials like tin or aluminum or precious metals like silver and gold. Although we have one system, we can run many guns on that system. We have an AK-7, which would be used on the largest possible parts with a very high spray rate. An AK-6, which is somewhat smaller, about 2/3 the power, slightly lower spray rate, but it's more versatile in terms of the size of the parts that you can spray without overheating them or without underheating them. Our AK-5 is a compact gun that is probably the most versatile product in our line of thermal spray equipment. We have a handheld version, a machine mount version, and an ID version. And in development is a rotating ID version as well. Our AK-ID has been around for years. The fixed version will get into 80 millimeters or 3.15 inches. We have a rotating version of the gun for parts which are difficult to rotate. The gun rotates, and that'll fit into 100 millimeter or 4-inch bores up to a depth of 600 millimeters or 2 feet. That'll spray it up to 10 pounds per hour. And we have a handheld version of that gun, as I mentioned, for manual spraying on difficult or complex surfaces. We use it for touching up welds or for difficult to spray parts where extensive manipulation, difficult to program, is required. Everything we run is cooled by air and runs off a simple operator tablet, which is handheld and can be moved around the spray cell as needed by the operator. We have also introduced recently the hybrid system. This is the oxygen-enhanced HVAF, if you care to think of it that way. We're producing coatings at a significant fraction of the cost of HVOF, due to the higher spray rates, the reduced consumption of oxygen, the high deposition per pass, and the fact that the system that runs The convertible system can also run our standard guns, so you can still add guns to fit the need. One of the benefits of the convertible system is that we can run with two converters, compressors, one dedicated to combustion, and you can use shop air for cooling, which eases the requirement for a dedicated compressor for HVAF. The specialized system, which we talked about, really has three main components, or three main guns. The STI for spraying titanium, the SL for low melting point materials that we've already mentioned for aluminum, copper, tin, zinc, and the SP system for precious metals. If you look at the photo on the left, you see the titanium being sprayed, and notice that there is no huge plume of oxidized material. The coating comes out pretty clean. On the right, you see a spraying tin. The coating is used in this particular case for anti-galling and anti-seizing on acne threads for industrial equipment. Here we have a chart of the comparison of properties of our AF coatings and the typical HVOF coating. You can see that in our economy mode, we have a deposit efficiency which is significantly higher or noticeably higher than typical HVOF. In balance mode, the deposit efficiency is going down, but as you can see, the hardness is rising. And finally, in the ultra mode, we have the lowest deposit efficiency, but the highest characteristics in terms of hardness. You notice also the Young's modulus of all our coatings is much, much better than in typical OF. This adds to durability through the ductility, which is maintained through the lack of dissolved oxygen. And as you can see, as we go from the economy mode to the ultra mode, porosity decreases significantly, whereas in ultra mode, we have virtually theoretical density. Bond strength is immeasurable. We simply break the glue at 12,000 PSI for everything we sprayed. And the finishing of these coatings for tungsten carbide is eased because of the fine surface texture that's achieved during spraying. Here we have an X-ray diffraction comparison of the feedstock powder and the as-applied coating. And as you can see, there's not very much difference. The fact is that the properties of the feedstock powder end up in the coating with very little alteration. And here we have a micrograph of a typical tungsten carbide coating. And I refer to this as boring metallography because no matter where you look, you're looking at the same thing. There's not really much to say about that photo, except the consistency is amazing. Here we have some cavitation resistance studies comparing an HVOF coating to our balanced coating in two versions of our ultra coating. As you can see, on the left at the bottom of the list, the details, you see a chrome nickel steel wears at a rate of 2 to 2.5 milligrams per hour in this standard test. And if you look up at the top of the chart, our ultra coating wears at 0.23 milligrams an hour, orders of magnitude better. As well, the second ultra coating, there's some variations in hardware there, and our balance mode coating significantly outperform a JP5000 coating in this cavitation evaluation. Silt erosion or particle erosion is another area of great concern where coatings are used. And here you see the steep line at the top of the, highest on the graph. That's a JP5000 HVOF coating. And you can see our economy, balance, and ultra modes all perform about the same and at a much higher level or reduced weight loss as compared to the HVOF coating. This is largely due to the ductility. Here we have yet another erosion test that was done in a competitive mode. All these other coatings were presumably first-class vendors of HVOF coatings. And as you can see, compared to our 6.23 milligrams per hour weight loss, the next best was at least twice that. And we won't even comment on the 59.35 milligrams per hour weight loss. It's hardly worth applying the coating. Here we have yet another erosion, this is cavitation rather, cavitation test. And we're comparing 316 stainless to a diamond jet coating and to our AK coating. Notice that the slope of the line is similar to the last test that was done, the lowest erosion rate of anything it was compared to in this test by a significant amount. This is an interesting test. It's a dry erosion test performed by Midwest Thermal Spray using sand, a powder feeder, and normal nitrogen carrier gas. And what's interesting is that the coating we created, because of the amazing ductility in it, actually performs better at 90 degrees than at 30 degrees. This is huge. Normally, you would expect hard things to do better at shallow angles of incidence, whereas ours is doing better at 90 degrees, where tough coatings usually only perform. We do something differently than many of the manufacturers of thermal spray equipment in that we run a job shop. It's our R&D facility. Everything that we've discussed in terms of the products we've developed all arose from real-life jobs that we do in our job shop. Our customers are primarily refiners. We're surrounded by them, but we also have steel mills and fiberglass manufacturers and such that use rolls, and we spray all sorts of parts in this shop. Everything we've done is based on a real-life job. Here we have a comparison of the titanium that we discussed earlier. On the left, in the upper left-hand corner, you see a dark patch coupon and one that's much lighter. If you look at the two photos, the one on the lower left is just an ordinary unaltered AK gun spraying titanium. And you can see how bright and energetic that spray plume is. And that results in the oxidized coupon you see on the left above. On the upper right, we have our shredder technology with the very controlled metal stream in the middle, and the result is the nice gray coupon you see in the upper left. The shredder technology works very well for spraying titanium. Here we have a close-up picture of the Acme threads that we're spraying tin on. Again, this application was so popular with our customer that we are now doing the entire inventory of U.S. parts that require tin coating on Acme threads for this manufacturer. We also spray augers and flights and barrels for material transport. Often, our coating is the only thing that works in certain applications. We have one customer that has an application for transporting bark chips, sand, rocks, dirt, and God knows what else. And his auger flights do very well, but the barrel takes a beating. So every barrel that goes out, we coat on the ID. This doesn't come up too often, but it comes up often enough to where we've done it more than once. This is a very, very costly roll. It's got floating segments that you can't see and pressure transducers to accurately gauge the pressure of steel running over it, so that the machine can constantly adjust to maintain the proper tension on the rewinders. The coating is 1.8 millimeters thick of 86-10-4 tungsten carbide cobalt chrome, and it gets ground and finished to a very, very high polish. Here's a application that's being done by our customer in Poland. They're very excited about our technology for doing boilers, boiler tubes, water wall tubes. They can blast with our gun and they can spray with the gun. And it is extremely forgiving, apparently, based on what they're telling us in the application. Around the world and in the United States, we have a number of distributors to assist us in dealing with the worldwide customer base that we enjoy. We have in China, Oriental Renpro, in Russia, Placart. Italy, we have Surface Coating Solutions, and in Poland, we have TMC. India, we have spray mat, Japan, new metals and chemicals, and Southeast Asia, we have Bexon Global. And there's one that's not on the list, plasma powders and processes in Marlborough, New Jersey. Thanks for listening.